Well, the World Economic Forum has estimated it'll take at least 170 years, and that keeps getting pushed further and further away in terms of gender parity. I think that part of the what I call the headwind, something that slows things down, is that a lot of what people understand about what diversity is gets in the way, ironically. I think people think diversity is what I call like Noah's Ark, which is, you know, let's just get two of each in the Ark, you know, and then we'll have our diversity. But as I often say, if the giraffe looks at the zebra and says, "You're funny looking. How do you do anything with that short neck of yours?" You know, then you don't really get, you know, because diversity is the path to innovation and creativity and ensuring that your workforce is fully engaged. But that's the end goal. So, you know, the best companies have figured out how to ensure that everyone gets heard. Because that's why even have your diversity if people aren't getting, if you aren't going to get the diversity of the ideas that you say you want. You know, so companies that know how to do that, that know how to make sure that people feel included, that people feel heard, you know, that they have the kinds of processes in place that make that happen. Yeah. I think that what happens is that companies say they want diversity, and then they get diversity, and they really don't know how to deal with it. Sometimes I see in corporations that people come into an organization quite diverse. Often many companies have 50% women, 50% men coming in to the company. But then when you look at the top of the company, you go, well, where did all the women go? They're gone, you know. So companies that have figured out how at each step, each level in an organization, that they have the processes in place that can truly analyze people based on merit, you know, not based on some unconscious belief that women don't have confidence, for example. Well, merit is the key. That's the basic platform. But the truth of the matter is how we evaluate women, how we evaluate men, how we evaluate other people who are in the non-dominant groups can be very, very different. You know, the tolerance for mistakes for women, for example, is less than the tolerance for mistakes for men. You know, I read a research recently that looked at the evaluations of top-level women and top-level men in over 200 companies. And what they found was in the evaluations that 76% of the comments about women and their evaluation were about communication style. 2% of the comments for men were about communication style. So the woman has sharp elbows, you know, that kind of thing. She's too aggressive or whatever. So unless you can prove to me that it is truly merit-based, I would say you probably haven't yet thoroughly understood what some of the dynamics are. Well, it's very important to get men engaged, particularly because most of the top leadership are men. You know, it doesn't make them bad people, it just makes them men. You know? And so you need, first and foremost, with a diverse organization, you must have the senior leadership commitment, the full commitment of that senior leadership. And also to understand that sometimes men see the world differently than women see the world. And often you'll find that men, in a funny sort of way, find that the reason that women, for example, don't get ahead is that they have work-life balance issues or they have family care issues, you know. And to a certain extent, that is true. But that's not the number one reason women don't get ahead. But it's a lot easier to justify that and not really have to change yourself. You say, well, it's a woman's choice. You know, she decided to leave. Well, no, you can have an organization that actually embraces women. You know, creates flexibility as needed, gives paternity leave, and then the men who are at the top role model taking paternity leave. There's a wonderful group called Male Champions of Change, And one of the things that the men have agreed to is they will not sit on a panel in a conference or a meeting unless it's 50% women and 50% men. Now, that's a good statement from men. It's crucial to have men engaged in this.